You are not Little Wayne. You are not Little Boozy. You are in the legacy and the mantle of Thurgood Marshall and Clarence Mitchell Sr. and Perrin Mitchell and Praisi and Fume. Get your black self up and change this city.
Actress Anna Deavere Smith brings her one-woman show Notes from the Field to HBO this week, a project where she interviewed over 200 people that experienced social injustice, from the Freddie Gray tragedy to the shooting in South Carolina. And she joins me right now. Anna, greetings from Las Vegas.
Hi, Jeff.
Anna, I saw Notes from the Field last night, and I'm telling you, it was so powerful. It was probably the most amazing one-woman show I've ever seen. Its message really drove home. You should be so proud.
Well, thank you for taking that time. I'm sure you had a lot of things you could have done last night.
So your message of social injustice and the system that is broken, especially with minority students and minority children, from the school to prison pipeline. And President Obama was the only, in his last term, was the only sitting president that visited a prison, and it was a bipartisan event, you know, to get prison reform. And now with President Trump and the Republicans trolling all of Congress and the White House, we hear nothing anymore about prison reform. What happened to that hope?
Well, you know, not just the hope, but the practicalness. I mean, one of the reasons that I think this was a rare issue that Democrats and Republicans could agree on is, from the Republican point of view, it's my understanding they just felt it was too expensive, you know, keeping people in prison. And so I think it's very important, for the reasons that you've just outlined, that we keep our eye on this. You know, just because something's not on the news doesn't mean that we shouldn't be paying attention, that we shouldn't be active.
Now, Anna, I took drama in high school and in college, and we did a lot of monologues, and you play 18 different characters in this show. So I asked actors that play so many characters, do you turn these characters off at night when you go home, or do some of them stay with you all the time?
Isn't that a great question? Actually, you know, by the time I get home from playing those plays on stage, it's usually about, you know, almost 2 hours that I'm performing. When I get home, all I do is fall sound asleep. So, no, I do shut the door on those characters. They can go off to sleep, and I go off to sleep.
So in Notes from the Field, you actually use the dialogue from your interviews. These are actual people's thoughts and feelings that you portray in all these different characters. Have you invited many or all of them to come see your show?
We invite everybody to see it, and now with the movie, we're inviting folks to come to screenings. And in fact, last night we had a screening in Harlem, and young Naya Kenny, who is a young lady who went to jail in Columbia, South Carolina, at Spring Valley High School, because she stood up in outrage when she watched one of her classmates being thrown across the room by a school police officer. Many of your viewers would have seen that footage. And she was there last night in New York, and it was very exciting to have her with us. So I try very hard to get folks to see it. One of the Native American people in the movie, the judge of the Yurok tribe, the chief judge, has gone all over the country seeing different versions of the play. And in fact, when I performed it in Berkeley, I sent a bus up to bring many people from the tribe down. So sure, I want those folks there to show up for real.
Now, I know in the past you said you can't choose which one of your favorite 18 characters. It's impossible for you. But I'll tell you, my favorite was Pastor Bryant. That was the most inspirational speech that was just phenomenal words. And his message of get up and make your lives better. I was standing out of my chair.
Yeah, well, Pastor Bryant is an extraordinary speaker, and he's really speaking in a tradition that combines both Christianity and activism. And that is just, to me, his eulogy. That was a eulogy for Freddie Gray, that some of your viewers will remember, Freddie Gray in Baltimore, Maryland, who was beaten by police officers. And it is said that he believed that he was killed while in police custody, that he died while in custody. And that, you know, that sermon was one rousing thing. And, you know, it reads very well on paper as well. So he's a good writer as well as a very, very dynamic preacher. Now, for me, that's the type of, it's not so much a favorite, but it's certainly the type of opportunity for me to become a better actor. It requires a lot of me emotionally. It requires a lot of me vocally.
And Anna, it was so fitting that you end your show with Congressman John Lewis, who was at Selma, who was there for Bloody Sunday, and his message of courage.
Well, you know, it's history. It's history, and in the case of the portrait of John Lewis, what's relevant about it is that the police officer now asks for forgiveness for the things that the police force did to him and other civil rights workers in the 60s, and makes this great gesture of saying, you know, to show that I am sorry. As I ask for your forgiveness, I want to take off my badge and give it to you as a symbol of, you know, the fact that, you know, we need to move on. And so I was just so happy to be able to get John Lewis to tell me that story, because I think the story itself marks a very important moment in our history right now. And of course, John is juxtaposed with a new civil rights warrior, Bree Newsom, who just saw the movie in Charleston last week. And Bree, your viewers may remember, is a young woman who climbed the flagpole in Columbia, South Carolina, to take down the Confederate flag after Dylann Roof went into a Charleston church and killed many black people while they were in prayer meeting.
And Anna, we had the Parkland school shootings, another mass shooting tragedy and kids being killed. And President Trump was golfing while they were burying those children, you know, mere 50 minutes away at his Mar-a-Lago resort in Florida. And I went online to see how President Obama handled, you know, a shooting event like shooting like in South Carolina. And he did that impromptu singing Amazing Grace at that service. And it was so moving.
Well, the important line in Amazing Grace is a line that saved a wretch like me. And as John Lewis says, what that line means is, you know, we have all fallen short. You know, we're all just trying to make it. We're all searching. And so I try in this movie, which is, you know, a social justice, you know, a rallying call, nonetheless, to show some humility. And I think through showing that humility, to suggest that we can all be better and it can all get better.
Well, Anna, thank you so much for speaking to me today. And you know what? I went to film school. I'm a filmmaker. So don't let Bill Maher bully you. I know you work at NYU. We need more filmmakers. We need more people to make the message out there. So don't let him bully you. We need filmmakers.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, he's a comic, that Bill Maher. We need them, too. But thank you so much for taking this time with me.
Total honor talking to you today, Anna. Thank you so much. And keep the faith.
All right. You, too.
Be sure to check out Notes from the Field by Anna Deavere Smith on HBO. And for more reviews and interviews, just surf on over to my website at vegasfilmcritic.com. Check me out on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And if you're watching on YouTube, please share, subscribe, and comment below. I'm Jeffrey K. Howard. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you next time.